So wheat is the second most important crop in India, as large number of people or large population in the country depends on wheat as a staple food. So it is a temperate crop and it is grown in winter, and the growing season is October, November, and we harvest it in the month of March and April. So this is a winter crop, and that's why it is known as Rabi crop, as it is grown in winter. So the staple food of many of Indians in north and northwestern part of the country, this is the second most popular cereal crop in India. If we look at the history, around 3000 BC, the wheat was grown in Middle East, and then with the advancement of trade, the demand increased and people started growing it extensively. And there are traces and evidences of wheat being grown in by the people of Indus Valley civilization, Egyptian civilization, as well as of Mesopotamian civilization. So this is a crop, prehistoric crop, like we have been growing this since long back. So it is very important crop, and in today's world, India stands fourth in the production of wheat in the whole world. So we are the fourth largest producer of wheat in the world. So this was a general introduction about the second most important staple crop, or we can say the cereal crop in India. So there are two types of wheat basically grown in India. One is spring wheat and another one is winter wheat. The name itself says about their time of sowing and harvesting. So the spring wheat, also known as Tritium vulgaris, and it is a softer variety of wheat which is usually used for making bread. So bread can be well prepared because it is a softer variety, and it is grown on irrigated land. So you know what, for cultivation of wheat, well-drained land and well-mechanized field, proper irrigation is very much required. So it is grown on irrigated land where soil is friable, loam and clay in nature. The soil should be friable, loam and clay in nature, and these are the requirements for growing spring wheat. The next variety is winter wheat, which is also known as Tritium durum, and this is a harder variety which is grown in South India, and it is well grown in black clay soil where rainfall is heavy. So in South India, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh are well suited for growing winter wheat in India. Spring wheat is mainly grown in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Uttarakhand. So in another India, as well as in southern India, different climatic conditions, they favor the growth of different types of wheat, spring wheat and winter wheat. Now let's look at the climatic conditions required for growing wheat in India. So first we'll start with temperature. So during the growing period, 10 degrees Celsius to 15 degrees Celsius of temperature is required, and during the harvesting period, the temperature required should vary from 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. Now, if we look at the rainfall, 50 to 100 centimeters of annual rainfall is ideal for cultivation of wheat, and if we see in the northwestern part of India, there the rainfall varies from 40 to 80 centimeters annually. Here, 12.5 centimeters of rainfall, which occurs during winter months caused by the western disturbances, is very helpful in cultivation of wheat. If there is shortage of rain, then it can be made up by using different modes of irrigation. Water can be provided artificially to compensate the lack of rainfall, or if there is less rainfall. very dangerous, very harmful for wheat, as it can damage the crops. If you look at the soil, the light clay or heavy loamy soil is ideal for cultivating wheat. And if we see in India, then the alluvial soil of Gangetic Plain and the black soil of Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh are very much suited for growing wheat. If there is lack of organic matter in the soil, then it can be supplemented by using fertilizers. But usually the alluvial soil and the black soil are very much rich in organic matter. But whatever is deficient, if nutrition is not provided properly to the wheat, then it will not grow well. So that can be supplemented by using fertilizers. So students, these are the climatic conditions required for growing wheat. The next topic is the methods of cultivation of wheat. So wheat is cultivated in winter, and it is basically sown in the month of October and November by using drilling method and broadcasting method. So these are the two common methods used in India to sow the seeds of wheat during the month of October and November, as it is a rabi crop. Now, what are the pre-requirements for cultivation of wheat? So before sowing the seed, the soil need to be moist. So the wheat seed is sown after the rainy season when the soil has enough moisture and it is moist. Sown after rainy season, so the soil is soft and can be plowed easily. If the soil is having enough moisture, it can be plowed easily, plowing can be done, and the soil can be made loose to sow the seed. After the seed is sown by using drilling and broadcasting method, the winter rainfall, which is again very helpful. If there is rainfall in winter, it is very helpful for wheat because it is a rabi crop, it grows in winter. But if rainfall is not sufficient, or if there is no rainfall in winter, then 3 to 4 times irrigation is required during the growing season. So if rainfall is not enough, it can be substituted by providing water through irrigation. Now students, after the cultivation is done, harvesting comes, season comes, and harvesting is done in April. In March the crop is ripened, and in April the crop is harvested. It is usually done by sickle. Here you can look at the picture of sickle. But now, sickle has been replaced by several new machines. With advancement, the primitive instrument, or we can say the tool, was used to harvest wheat has been removed. And now we use, you can see in the picture, these devices, these implements to harvest wheat. And this modernization in harvesting can be seen mostly in Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. And this has happened after the introduction of Green Revolution in India. So as a result of Green Revolution, several times the production of wheat increased in India, and wheat is the only crop which has seen such a sharp rise in production in the country. So this is about the harvesting and the cultivation methods of wheat. Now let's move to the regions where wheat is cultivated in India. In contrary to rice, rice need flooded field, but wheat require moist soil which can be plowed easily. So 87% of wheat comes from Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan and Bihar. And you know students, these 5 states, they are together known as the granary of India, because the maximum wheat production comes from these 5 states. 87% of the total production comes from here. If we talk about South India, area. Then black soil tracts of Deccan covering Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. It is also suitable for growing wheat. Uttar Pradesh is the largest producer of wheat in India. Let's look at the climatic contrast between wheat and rice. So these are the two most important cereal crops in India. So let's look at the climatic contrast. In case of wheat, it is a rabi crop, whereas in case of rice, it is a kharif crop. Wheat, the temperature required is from 10 degrees Celsius to 15 degrees Celsius, whereas in case of rice, temperature required is from 20 degrees Celsius to 32 degrees Celsius. And if we see the rainfall requirement, then wheat requires 50 to 100 centimeters of rainfall annually, whereas rice requires much more rainfall, that is from 150 to 300 centimeters of rainfall annually. If we talk about mechanization and requirements, then extensive farming is encouraged in case of wheat with high mechanization, which is comparatively less in case of cultivation of rice in India. If we talk about the requirement of the soil condition, then wheat requires moist soil which can be plowed easily, whereas in case of rice, it is sown in flooded field. So this is how the climatic contrast is there in between these two cereal crops grown in India, rice and wheat.
That's all in this module. Thank you.